Praise the Lord.
Have you seen the Lord's goodness? His mercies are
and compassion. Have you seen the Lord's goodness? Hallelujah, praise the Lord, hallelujah.
Oh, worship His holy name. I appreciate Him for all He has done for you. Thank Him for His faithfulness, for His love, for His mercy, for His protection, for His provision, for His guidance. So many people are in the mortuary, we are here today. It's not because we deserve it. It's not because we want it. It's by the grace of God. Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, Blessed be your name, Father. For in Jesus' name we worship.
I said, listen. I'm going to reason with you. I'm reasoning with you. When you sleep, you go to bed, you sleep in it. But when you get up in the morning, what's it? Tell me, yes, you said, when you get up in the morning, what's it? I said, Anastas. Hallelujah. Every day is a day of resurrection for every believer. Not only once a year as a believer in the Lord that truly serve the Lord. And that's as you say every day for us in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Please help me, my brother, with this song. I need it.
Come, Holy Spirit, we need you.
People challenge me. That's it. The end of the morning, certain guy just attacking me. Said, everything I see is work of the devil. That means the devil is more popular than God. Early in the morning, who would answer such a question? It takes the wisdom of God to put down those that try to demean your God. I told this gentleman, I said, the day of ignorance, God will not. And call everybody to do what?
To repentance.
And that's what you're feeling. Because God is alive and He's walking amidst you. I don't know which kind of group you belong to, but in my groups, I see God doing what? Walking, doing wonders, performing things. I told you, I said, go to your computer, Google it, and said, write what God is doing in the world today. You will see, you will count your things. I just thank God for those that put those things on the internet. So God shall love my brothers and sisters. But that's the puzzle. He said, so the mandor also happens to you too. You ask yourself, why do bad things happen to good people? People have asked me, even in my class, why do bad things happen to Christian believers? Thank God, God has an answer for every question of this world. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
So, Lord, just our Lord Jesus Christ told us the reason is that because we speak. He speaks in parable. Well, when I ask him this, the last one asked him, why do you speak in parable to the people? Try to be able to, therefore, be able to, and they define themselves with the situations. So turn with me to Matthew chapter 13. Matthew chapter 13. The old 13 is full of parables. Even one of my disciples told her to read this parable. Unfortunately, she did not. Matthew 13.
The previous parable, Jesus spoke about the word being sown in the hearts of people. Just like the pastor said, why do you see they were hungry? When they were angry with Jesus, because Jesus was saying the word that really aggravated them. Hallelujah. Verse 24, Matthew 13, verse 24. Then another parable put it forth unto them, saying, the kingdom of heaven is like unto a man which sowed good seed in his field. Please follow it. Which sowed good seed in his field. But while men slept, his enemy came and sowed tares among the wheat and went his way. Please mark the word slept. And when the blade was spring up and brought forth fruit, then appeared the tares also. Please mark the word appear, because we will be teaching that on that appears. So the servant of the householder came and turned to him, sir, did not thou sow good seed in the field? For when there comes, it at the tares. And said unto them, an enemy has done this. Man the word, an enemy has done this. Then the servant said unto him, with that we go and gather them up? But said, no. That's why you gather up the tares, you root up also the wheat with them. Verse 30. Let them grow together until harvest. And the time of harvest, I will say to the reapers, gather ye together first the tares, bind them in bundles to burn them, but gather the wheat into my barn. Hallelujah. When he spoke this parable to his disciples, they didn't understand it. That's why when you have any questions, always ask the person that you know that can answer the questions for you. Verse 36. That's why I used to stand in my class. I said, please, you have any question, ask me. I don't know everything, but I know the God that knows everything.
Hallelujah.
He knows everything, and he has never disappointed me. Even when I know, I would say, look, I'm going to research. I will find out. I give you bring the answer to you.
So verse 36 said, then Jesus sent the multitude away and went to the house. And Zabu came unto him, saying, declare unto us the parable of the tares of the field. And now Jesus began to answer them. He answered and said to them, he that soweth the good seed is the Son of Man. The field is the world. The good seed are the children of the kingdom, but the tares are the children of the wicked one. The enemy that sowed them is the devil, and the harvest is the end of the world, and the reapers are the angels. As therefore the tares are gathered and burned in the fire, so shall it be in the end of this world. The Son of Man shall send forth his angel, and shall gather out of his kingdom all things that offend and them that which do iniquity. Please mark the word all things that offend, that do this iniquity. And so shall cast them into a furnace of fire.
there shall be wailing and gnashing of teeth. Then shall the righteous shine forth as the sun in the kingdom of their Father. Who hath ears to hear, let him hear.
This parable here talks about Christian living. All of us believe this world together. You see the wicked ones, you see the righteous walking together. There's a time a Satan challenged me. He said, why can't God destroy devil so that he will start stopping us? And I said, it's the time for them to be destroyed, not yet. Not yet. The time is coming. That devil will burn. How many years? That was called that. You don't know?
Yeah.
1,000 years will burn. Where the world will experience the rulership of God. Devil will not be able to. But now, according to the Bible, we, the righteous, we will be together with them. But God said, we have to shine. We will shine. Forth. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So, in this parable, my dear brothers and sisters, you see how devil tried to touch your people. And God said, the one that's so passive is who? The devil. You know, the devil has an agenda. Three agenda: to steal, to kill, and to destroy. That agenda is still active today. And then what Jesus said, what I have come to what? To give life. What? In abundance. So it's God's will for us, we believers that trust in Him, to live a good life, not a sick life, not a wicked life, not a destroyed life. But what God tells us that, as we read there, that the field are the children of the kingdom. So what's happened? What you are beginning, you know, if they are sleeping, spiritual sleep. But you need physical sleep to sleep, right? To gain your strength. But that in these days, we are just wondering, say, why, what's happened to the church today? What's happened to the believers? What are God's telling us to say? That when they are sleeping, whatever, when you're spiritual, when you're sleeping spiritually, the enemy is waiting for an opportunity to sow his wickedness. And what he does is trying to sow bad seed into your heart. So I wonder sometimes people, we are working together, they live together happily, then after some years, what happened? They began to hate one another. What's that? The enemy has done what? Some bad seed in there. Oh, today you are happy. Next tomorrow you are not happy. What's happened? The enemy has done what? What God said, we're not ignorant of the devil devices. Most of us, we are ignorant. Some of us, when we see maybe trouble coming this way, instead of us to run, we do what? We set the table before the trouble and begin to serve coffee and food. Then what happened? Everything erupts. You know, Proverbs said, when you see a trouble, what God is, you know, it takes great strength to run away from trouble. Get great strength and great wisdom to say, no, I'm not ready for this. I will not attend this. Or say, simple word, I'm sorry. Forgive me. Then, that's how you don't allow devil to sow his bad seed into your relationship, into your marriage. Because when you are sleeping, the enemy does what? It's so bad. Tell yourself, I will never be a victim to devil.
I will never be a victim of the devil.
Yeah. Because most of us, we are a victim of the devil. But every day is working. Not only one person. Everywhere is working. Try to sow his bad seed in the life of people. To destroy them. But when you attach yourself to the Lord, then you don't give room for the devil. But God said, don't give room to him. or shall not be given rule what happened. It will take over. It will take over and ruin it. So because I've been wondering why this is happening at the believers today. Why? At the end of the answer is here. Spiritual strength. And I've decided I've not stayed spiritually. At times when I come back from work, when I feel so tired, and then at time for me to pray, I cannot pray. No, I have to wake up. I have to pray. Because why? The word of God tells us we have to what? Watch and do what? And pray. That we don't what? Enter into what? Temptation. So watch and pray. So we have seen this parable here that we are the source of the kingdom. And the enemy is trying to destroy us, not to allow us to enter the kingdom of God. By sowing bad seed into us. But we not allow that in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The enemy will not be able to have a grant over us in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I come to discover that what the enemy used this last day for against Christians, but one is anger. I had to be when they quarrel. What's the problem? If they tell you the problem, you say, you're arguing on this kind of thing. Does he want it? Doesn't want it. I read the story of a certain father. He bought a new car. And he was everything with his friends as well. Then his son just took a certain thing like that and began to write something on the car. And the father was so angry. And he smashed the boy's fingers. Then the same father that smashed the boy's fingers took him to the hospital. The doctor told the father, said, we have to cut this guy's fingers, otherwise he will affect somebody. All right. So they have to cut this boy's fingers. And the boy asked the father, will my finger grow again? Then when they came home, the father was so much annoyed with himself what he has done. You know what happened to him? He committed suicide out of regret. This is what anger can do. That's why it's very important not to be angry. God said, be hungry and do what? You don't sin. What does it mean there? It means that you have to keep on the attitude of love. You're angry, but I still love you. Even the same thing, we've got to read the Bible. God's angry with his people. He should do what? He should show them mercy. Means them love and kindness. Because if you know your God, you know how to handle people. You know how to treat people. You know how to understand people. That people, the enemy tried to sow bad seed into them so that they can affect your life. Every day I'm with unbelievers and I know what they do, what they say. Well, they say many things against me, but because I have the shield of faith, I also have the element of what? Salvation. So what they are saying, the enemy just take over. Oh, you got it. Go back to them. It doesn't reach me. So I know I will not allow the enemy to sow bad seed into me. Hallelujah. Also, the other thing that the enemy sowed into, let's go to Galatians chapter 5. Galatians chapter 5. Let us read the bad seed that enemy sowed in the life of people. Galatians chapter 5. Verse 19. Galatians chapter 5, verse 19. These are the things the enemy tried to sow in life of believers. He said, now the work of the flesh are manifest, which are these: idolatry, fornication, greediness, lasciviousness, idolatry, witchcraft, hatred, violence, emulations, wrath, strife, seditions, heresy, envy, murders,
drunkenness, reveling, and such of this which I tell you before, that I've also told you in time past, that they which do such things shall not inherit the kingdom of God. Jesus said in the Bible, he said, of those are people of friends that do in iniquity, they're not part of the kingdom. And these are the things that cause offense. They are things that cause offense. If you find yourself in this thing written here, this one the Lord wants to destroy it in our lives. So that the enemy have to have a future in our life. Then you know anything to do with us in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Because God tells us in the last days, there will be tough times that will lead many souls to be turned away from the Lord. These are the things the enemy use to destroy us. But we say, no, you will not destroy me in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You don't have a part in me in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Let's also go to Colossians chapter 3 and see other things the enemy use. How he sowed his wickedness to destroy believers. Colossians chapter 3. Colossians chapter 3. Verse 5. Apostle Paul is going to say also there. Say, mortify therefore your members which are upon the earth. The same thing we read in chapter 5, fornication, uncleanness, inordinate of inordinate affections, evil consequences, and covetousness, which is idolatry. For which things sake the wrath of God cometh on the children of disobedience, in which he also walked some time when he lived in them. Praise God for that. But now you also put off all this anger, wrath, malice, blasphemy, filthy communications out of your mouth. Hallelujah. Lie not one to another, seeing that you have put off the old man with his deeds. Hallelujah. Oh. Verse 10. And now I've put on the new man, which is renewed in knowledge after the image of him that created him. God, praise the Lord. These are the things the enemy puts, trying to sow into us. But if you are aware of it, when you see, maybe your heart begin to become angry against somebody, what do you do? Maybe your husband or wife aggravates you. What do you do at that time? And you know, it's about to come. What do you do? If you know how to pray in the Spirit, you pray in the Spirit. If you know how to sing in the Spirit, sing in the Spirit. So that your anger will calm down. Then you can talk normally. Because when you're angry, you say things that you later regret. You say things that you regret. I've been in that position before. That's why I try to calm myself down. Oh, I ask Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, please walk in me. Sometimes we don't take advantage of Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, walk in me. He does the work. He does the work for us. So I'll be able to walk in the work of righteousness with the Father. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
So we should watch and pray. The solution here, Apostle Peter gave us the solution. Let's go to 1 Peter chapter 5. 1 Peter chapter 5. Verse 8. In these last days, my brothers and sisters, you need to be watchful. God said, be sober, by one. You have to be what?
Vigilant.
Yeah, you have to be sober. That means try to
control your emotions, yourself. Then, number two, say what? Be vigilant. I'm a vigilant person, the one that we're talking spiritually, I'm talking about. Even spiritually, you have to be vigilant too. But when you're walking on the road, if you're not vigilant, you know what happened to you?
Accident.
Okay, it works. But you have to be vigilant. Why? Because you are destroying the devil. As a roaring lion, walking about seeking whom may devour. Oh, just say to yourself, devil, you not devour me in the name of Jesus. Neither my children.
Neither my family.
He will not devour me in the name of Jesus.
I'm
telling you, he will not devour me.
Amen.
I have seen one of my brothers just call me, so he says he has his court case. And they need a paper. And that the man was supposed to give me that paper, he was playing him. I need that paper very seriously and urgent for the Lord to use. Then this brother was so angry. I said, brother, listen. If you want to get anything from God, don't be angry. Because when that means if you are angry, that means you are taking the position of God. But what God said, be still. In that scripture, I said, be still. I know that there's a God that's working on your behalf. At 2 o'clock in the morning, when I finished my prayer, I just sent a message, Psalm 70. Well, said, I said, make haste to help me, Lord. Speedily. So, the following day, I sent a text maybe on Wednesday, yes. Then on Thursday, then he called me and said, the Lord is touching this man's heart. Okay? Then on Friday, he told me, said, not this paper, instead of him going to pick out this paper from the man, the man brought the paper to him. I'm telling you, because they want to use that man against our brother. But when our brother takes the right attitude, that's very important. The right attitude is very important. But God knows our hearts. He knows what you're thinking. Nobody said, I pray, I fasted, I didn't receive from God. But I don't know your heart. I don't hear what you say. But there's no time that you cry to God doesn't answer you. What God said, His word is what? Yea and amen. He always answers. Sometimes I have myself asked God, the things I've asked God that He's not given to me. But He knows better. He knows that maybe if I get that thing, He may destroy me. That's why I just trust His sovereignty. Say, Father, if I don't get it, I trust you. You have something better for me. He has always proven it, something better. When you have the right attitude. So don't allow the enemy to sow his doubt or his wickedness in your heart. Don't allow it. Because it's hard to do what? To sow his wickedness. So that you're able to destroy and steal your heart. So what God said, then verse 9, whom resisted fast in the faith. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So when the devil tried to tempt you, cause it's evil against you, evil, you can stand for your children too. When the devil's trying to attack them, you have to stand. Just stand in faith. Trust in the Lord. Trust the Lord. And keep on pressing on. Know that the same afflictions are accomplished in your brethren that are in the world. I love verse 10. Hallelujah.
Mm-hmm.
Oh! Say, but the God of all grace.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. The God of all grace. That means the God of all empowerment.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah. He will always be there. To do what? Who has called us unto His eternal glory by Christ Jesus. After you have suffered a while, make you perfect,
mm-hmm.
establish you, strengthens you, and do what?
Setting
you. It's a God of completion.
Amen.
Never do any half job.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Not only establish you, He will settle you.
Amen.
And we keep on settling you. He will not stop until the day He will call us to His glory.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I come to the point, remember just reading this parable of the wheat and the weights and so on. The Word of God declared to us that sometimes we're trying to bind things that need to be uprooted. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But let's go to Jeremiah chapter 1. I'm going to close with that. Jeremiah chapter 1. Jeremiah. Chapter 1. Jeremiah chapter 1. Verse 8. Let's start it from verse 8. The Lord speaking to Jeremiah here. The same thing speaking to us today. He said, be not afraid of their faces. For I am with thee to do what? To deliver thee. Say whom? Say the Lord. Whatever he says to Jeremiah, he said it to you this morning.
Amen.
Is with us to deliver us.
Amen.
Then he continued verse 9. Then the Lord put forth his hand and touched my mouth. And the Lord said unto me, behold, I put my words in thy mouth.
Amen.
He has put his word in our mouth. How does he do it? By we reading the word of God. How does God speak to us? Through his word. How do we speak to God? Through prayer. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yeah. And then sometimes it's not bad to ask your brother to join your prayer, but you have to do your prayer too yourself. Your prayers yourself too. Verse 10 I'm going to. See, have this day said the over what? The nations and over the kingdoms. Are you qualified? Eh? You know Jeremiah is called, is set over the nations and kingdom. It's not the nations, kingdom. But it's kind of not only the kingdom, but we got the kingdom of darkness. That's what you said. To do what? Number one, to root out. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Whatever is not of God in you, that be what?
Amen.
Root out in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Then continue. And also, to what? To pull down. To pull down. That's what the master told his servant. To do what? To root out, to pull down the weeds that the enemy has sown. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Then, and to destroy. This is what the master did. Well, after he root out all these things and pull down, they do what? They destroy the weeds. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And to throw down. That's what they do. Then they begin what? To build and to plant. It's one of the secrets in prayer. In the spiritual warfare. Sometimes there are things that we need to root out, to pull down, but we begin to bind. And we don't see things working. You say, why? It's not enough to bind. You need what? To root out. You need to root out the hunger in you. You need to root out that jealousy. You need to root out that evil thoughts you have towards your brothers. You ask me, can Christian have evil thoughts against his brothers or sisters? Eh?
You are the first one.
Apostle Paul said, I am the chief of all sinners. Imagine that. But all those things, now you have to understand it. So do what? You mean when the Holy Spirit begins to show you that thing that the enemy has tried to sow into your life, do what? You begin to root out. Come on, you anger, get out of me in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You jealousy, get out of me in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And then you begin to plant. Right now, I'm going to plant the word of God in me. I'm going to plant the thought of God in me. I'm going to plant the rest of God in me. And begin to build. Sometimes we do that, but we don't build. Remember the story of Jesus where he said that when you cast out the devils, then what happened? If you cast it out, they went again around and brought more wicked ones. And then the worst it was that person, so nobody bothered the biggest one.
Why? Because they find the place what?
Empty.
This happened with us. You root out, you pull down, you destroy, but you didn't build. We have to tell people. I said, after we pray for you, please don't think the battle is won. It's not won. You have to keep on pressing on in faith, trusting the Lord. Read your Bible. Be with your brother, brothers and sisters. But in this last day, my brothers, we need one another. Thank God for this magic phone. Those that you have, try to call them. Say hello. In honor of the time is so limited for us, we don't have time for one another, but at least we can take 2 minutes to say, hello, my brother, how are you doing? Is there anything I can agree with you in prayer? Does it cost any? What does it cost? But we need one another in this time. Because the devil is seeking to destroy the believers. He's seeking to destroy the church. But you will not have his way in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
So we have to trust in God. Hallelujah. I want us to stand on our feet. God's going to do some serious prayer. Hallelujah. Oh Lord, come down and manifest your power. Oh Lord, come down and manifest your power. Sing it with your heart. Oh Lord, come down and manifest your power. Oh Lord, come down.
Begin to put them down from my life. Begin to put them down from my environment in the name of Jesus.
Begin to ask God this morning. The Father, from now on, plant your own righteousness in me.
Yes,
plant your own holiness in me. From now on, Lord,
I will pray.
Plant your own righteousness in me, Lord.
I will pray.
Righteousness in our nations.
Amen.
Righteousness in our nation.
Amen.
The fear of God in our nation. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Thank you, blessed Redeemer. And thou forever glorified, O Lord, for great is your faithfulness.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore.
Amen.
Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
We shall not die, but live to declare the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living.
Amen.
Shall not die, but live to declare the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living.
Amen.
I shall not die, but live to declare the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living.
Amen.
Shalom.
If you have been following us online and you've not made Jesus your Lord and your Savior, and it is your desire to do so, I want you to make this confessional prayer with me. Lord Jesus, I know that you are the Son of God. I confess before you today that I am a sinner, and I need you to forgive me of all my sins. I accept you in my life as my Lord and my personal Savior. Give me the power to be a child of God. Help me by the power of your Holy Spirit to live a life that is pleasing unto you. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name I pray. And again, if you are blessed by our message and that you need a prayer or you need a word of encouragement or counseling, you can reach us with this telephone number +30 6955006192. I repeat again, +30 6955006192. Do not forget to invite your friends, share our link with them, and God will bless you as you do that. Amen.